Hey guys, welcome back to another video. As you can see, I've got the Lego NASA Space Shuttle Discovery set. It is a very nice set. So this is going to be a review of it. So as you can see here, it is very big. If I just grab a minifigure, you can see it is like, it is not minifigure scale. It's too small to be minifigure scale, but you can still shows the size of the set. So it's very big. It's more of a nanofig scale set. I'll show you a nanofig in there. But even then, to scale of even the Lego NASA Standard Polar 5, it's a little bit bigger to be scaled of that. But the amount of detail that they've put into this set, you can kind of understand that it needs to be a bit bigger to fit this all in there. Okay, we're gonna start off these stands. So these are both just big stickers on each. They are very simple builds, as you can see. If you'd like to read what's on them, you can just simply pause the video. Alright, coming over to the main attraction of the set, which is the NASA Space Shuttle Discovery. So as you can see, it's on this very nice stand, which simply just, this whole thing can come straight off. And you can see it's literally just those. There's no studs or anything in there attaching to it. It's just those little flat things that in there. You can see those. That's where they come into. So it makes them quite easy to put on. Just simply, if I can get it on there. Just like that, it is on there. So yeah, that stand did take a while to build. It's quite a nice stand, but it's just, yeah. It's easily holding up the whole set with no issue, so it works. Looking at the front of the space shuttle, this is just the cockpit. We can take a look inside there. And it's actually got a mini, I've actually put a nanofig in there. And you can tell, even the nanofig, it's probably too big to fit in the set. So really, if I wanted this to be the scale of anything, they would have to make it bigger. But yeah, so that's just a nanofigure from the Saturn V in there. And you can see the hole. You can see the hole in there. There's lots of little computers and screens in there. Yeah. So that, this is actually two layers to the cockpit. There's obviously main layer with, or is that, oh, that's not the main layer. This is main layer. In here, you can see in there, there's four seats with a whole pile of little computers. Should actually be another tail. And this thing simply just pops straight onto there. There's no studs holding it. Oh, there is. There's studs holding it in, but just there. So it makes it come out very easily. Before we look at anything else, I'm just going to show you all the stickers. So pretty much, this set uses printed and, well, this set uses printed stickers like here, here, and then there's actual stickers like in here, and there's a lot of stickers, actual stickers in the inside. So, to start with, there's NASA Discovery. That's a print. Over to the other side is the USA. I quite like that one a lot. That's very nice. And then there's these little United States. Those are both printed. And yeah, that's on both sides, and this NASA thing is on both sides, but that's a real sticker. Yeah. And then over here is Discovery. That's on both sides of the stickers. Here is actually a new mold, which is very cool. Hopefully it comes over to other sets, but it may not. And it's got an exclusive print on it as well. Looking over to the back of the set, it's very detailed. These things are actually adjustable on either side, so you can get them to your preferred angle. These little side engines can pop out, and you can see the engine in there on both sides. And all these little engine things, shouldn't be saying things, but I am. With the top one, you can actually tilt the wings to adjust the direction you're going in. Yeah, so that's a very cool little feature. Over to the side of it, you kind of just got, actually this set is pretty wide. You can see how wide it is. in there. It's just all these stickers. This wasn't a very hard set to build. Some parts were, like, I messed up a little bit. Where was it? Over here, this was, I actually found out just before that this was not in the right position. It was a bit too high, so I lowered it down. And that actually gave the space for this to all go on properly, because I could tell this thing was not, this was not put in properly, but it was because of where I put this. So I fixed that, and it's all good. Yeah. There is one part of the set which is not enjoyable to build, to assemble, but we'll get into that soon. If we take this set off the stand, you can see I've got the Hubble telescope right there. We'll look at that soon. Pretty much, it's actually just sitting on its base right now. And I'll show you the base. It's not very interesting. It's just pretty much all black. You can, this little glimpse of what I'm about to show you. Those little landing gears, and pretty much this little part here, if we press that, see this? See that? Those popped up, and so did that one. And now we have retractable landing gear, so this thing can actually park properly and go across without having to scrape the Lego because it actually got wheels. So that's a very cool little part of the set. And take a closer look. Yeah, it's pretty much just, there's springs in there which do it, and to put these back, it's pretty much just push them in. There's no mechanical way to get them back in. You've got to do it manually. Coming over to the main part of the set, which is the fact that this can open. So it's quite a cool little feature. And yeah, you can probably see all these little reflective bits. I think these are meant to be solar panels, but believe it or not, these are all stickers. So there's quite a few of them, and they were not very fun to put on there because there's just heaps of them. Some of them are big. You don't want to mess them up. So actually that one is a little bit messed up. Some of them just, I think I did a pretty good job of them, but maybe there it's a bit off, but yeah. I'll show you. Yeah. So, sorry about that shake. But yeah. Those stickers, it took me a while, and there's a lot to put on there. And you don't get any spares, so if you mess one up, and if you put one on and it's really unstraight, you may be forced to peel it off and put it back on. I had to do that a couple times. But yeah, so apart from that, in here is where the Hubble telescope can go in. I'll show you that soon. That comes up, and this can be fully adjusted. Yeah. That just goes back in there. It's quite a little nice little feature. And in here, there's just all these little security cameras. One there, and one there, a couple there. Yeah. And in there, there could be more, but they need to leave space for the Hubble. Yeah. And that obviously leads into, that's supposed to be like an airlock door. It doesn't actually do anything to get into the cockpit. And yeah, that's a little speaker, I believe it is. It could be something different, but yeah. It's a little United States flag. Moving into the last part of the set, which is the Hubble telescope. Once again, this is a very nice build. You actually see, if we take this off the stand, which is pretty easy to take off, these are all metallic kind of printed things, but you can probably see little scratches. See all those scratches? They're all in the same spot. That means that was not by me. That would have been caused by some machinery in the Lego factory, because you can see scratches on every single one of those. Pretty much the same spot. So I don't know what happened there, but it's pretty scratched. So maybe it's just the process of doing this can be hard, because they do look very good, and you got to pay attention to notice that they're scratched. But yeah, look at that. Those are big scratches. So apart from that, there's pretty much these solar panels, which are fully adjustable. They're very nice to use. On either side, inside, obviously that can open a little. That's the telescope thing in there. Over to the other side, there's this little vault door. There's a steering wheel on it. Not sure what it's supposed to represent. I don't know a whole lot about the Hubble, but yeah. And there's these little things. And in there, see those?
That's where it attaches to the stand, just through those.
So it makes it very easy to attach. There's this little NASA piece here, which is printed. It's very nice. And yeah, so I'm going to show you how this goes into the space shuttle.
You can see I've got the Hubble telescope in there. It looks like it's been held up by this arm, but in fact, there's actually that big black thing, because obviously that would not be strong enough, because actually in space, it's simply just gravity holding that in place. This thing would just be there, so it doesn't fly away. That's all. And you can see we can keep the solar panels on there, or you can take them off and replace them with these, which are just there for looks, I guess. When it's in there, it's not very adjustable. You can pop it out, but it's not going to hold up without that piece in there. So when that's in there, that's going to hold up very well, and you got yourself a very nice display of the Hubble telescope and the space shuttle. So yeah, that's pretty much all there is to talk about this set. Leave a comment below what you really like about the set and what set you want me to get next. I do have a couple ideas. It won't be till wee well into next year, because I do need to start saving my money, and I've got some other things that I'd want to get first. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. Have a good day.